there is this kind of sense that, that the politicians, they failed the nation. I mean, there was this, it's clear that the whole political class didn't do their job. I mean, they're kind of, the banks, they were allowed to expand and to grow and to do what they were doing, you know, without any kind of supervision by the people who were elected to supervise. And so people, I mean, I think the kind of demand for transparency is based on the idea that, that there is a lack of trust. I mean, that's clear. And there is a very good reason why people do not trust the politicians. I mean, it's clear that, that the whole system, the collapse happened because they're not doing their job. I mean, there was no accountability. And there is a sense that, that nothing has really happened to, you know, the bad guys who are seen as the bad guys, you know, the banksters, as they are called. I mean, that they are still, you know, free. I mean, why is a person put into prison if he or she steals, you know, packets of cigarettes? And if you steal $1 billion, I mean, you are living in London in luxury. I mean, that's because it's clear that these people were stealing. I mean, they were doing that in maybe in a legal manner, but at least in the end they are not going to pay for it. So I think that is also one of the kind of fuel. It's the fuel to that kind of sentiment that there has to be some kind of recognition of the, you know, that people have to be able to follow what's happening, because in the end we are responsible. So there are people always saying, I mean, and this is one of the kind of ideas behind this, is that, well, people there were silent in 2007. I mean, no one was complaining. I mean, we had a fantastic life. I mean, people were buying things like crazy and running up debts because they were cheap, and they were quite happy with it. And then everything collapses, and then people say, why didn't you say something in 2007 when there was still a time? And, you know, one possible answer is that people didn't know. I mean, people were not asking the question. So I think there is this kind of sense that the only way we can prevent this from happening is to be that we are following what the politicians are doing, and so far that is going on. Mm-hmm. But it has been a very strange period of time. I'm a historian, so one of my fields is French history, and so I have, you know, read quite a bit about the French Revolution. And there was this sense in early 2009 that Iceland was on the brink of a revolution. I mean, and I was very amazed, because Iceland had always been a very tranquil society, as a non-revolutionary society, and there's always been a very strong sense of law-abidingness and kind of respect for authority and things like that, at least some respect. But suddenly people, you know, were screaming in the street and just saying, wanted to kick, you know, all people in power out. And so there was this kind of moment of where you can see, like, people hesitating on the precipice, and should we jump or should we not? And then a few days later, kind of retracted. And it was amazing for historian to watch. I mean, because revolutions never happen when authority is strong. Revolutions always happen, I'm talking about real revolutions, you know, like revolutionary societies like the French Revolution, the Russian Revolution. I mean, these revolutions happen when authority has collapsed, when the kind of power system, the government has really collapsed. Then the revolution comes in, the revolutionaries come in and fill the kind of vacuum, of power vacuum. And there was this kind of sense in Iceland in 2009, January 2009, that there was power vacuum that had to be filled. And, like, as I say, I mean, there was this kind of, maybe a week where it could have gone either way. And in the end, people decide, okay, let's change government and see what happens.
Yeah.